In 3, 2, 1, here we go. All right. So we had started these notes yesterday. So we've gone through. I know I gotta move. Let's see. Where did I get to? Oh, just quick review. So, if it is inside, you take arc plus arc divided by 2 equals that angle 1. Okay? So if it's inside, if it's outside, it's minus. So inside, you add, and that'll equal that. So that means big arc plus small arc divided by 2. So that was what that was. And then those work there. But then if you had arc and arc, so you take big arc minus small arc divided by 2 equals angle 1 on that one. So if it's exterior, it's subtraction. If it's an interior angle, it's addition. So it's the same idea. And this means big arc minus small arc. You understand the stirrups, stirrup logo. Got it right? So again, that's what this is. If I have this and this, if I subtract those and divide by 2, I get this. That's it. That's it. Is it, if 1's an exterior angle. Okay.
1 times 2 is C, right?
No.
That'd be 2.
So if I called this segment here X and this Y, it would be X minus Y divided by 2 would equal angle 1. That's the math that we're taking place. So the difference between this one and this one is these are the chords inside. If I had this, X and Y, I'd go X plus Y over 2 equals angle 1. So this angle is meeting inside. Being this is an exterior, it has to be a minus. So they're very similar equations. Yes, sir.
Did you do it Y minus X over 2?
Y?
Or does it have to be the bigger one?
Well, you don't want to have a negative arc length. I mean, I guess how you could change it, you could say it's the absolute value of whatever that comes, and that's going to work as well. It's just I'm trying to say, you know, if you take the big, if you go the small minus the big, you get a negative number. Realize you're not going to get a negative angle. So just make sure it's always positive. Yeah. Yo. Say that one more.
What if the lines is a
tangent? Oh, we're going to get into that today. All right, so going forward, we talked to that. We're talking about that. Yeah. All right, so I think this is where we needed to be. Yes?
Yeah.
I think that, so I had just gone over this. Yes, I have all the hidden stuff. This was the last theorem we talked about. Okay? So, if we're here. So let's just make this happen. Let's go, I don't know. Bust out. Let's do some crayons. I like crayons. So I have this and I have this. And on this one, we'll do red crayon. Did I ever tell you my story about a red crayon?
No, please do.
Yes, go.
So when I was in first grade, 1977, there was a band that came out that we all loved, and then all these church groups cut and were saying that, you know, it's an acronym for Kids in Satan Service. It's the band known as KISS, my favorite band. So in 1977, they played Arizona State Fair. So my friend Zach Pace's mom said, when we were in first grade, I will take you in, you can watch 2 of the songs during this concert. So when I was in first grade, I saw 2 songs performed in concert by KISS. So Zach and I get back to school, and it was Zach's fault. He convinced me to do this, but it's okay. Zach was still a good guy. We used to steal. I noticed Zach out at recess, and he starts spitting, and it's just blood. just pouring out his mouth. He's like, oh man, that's so cool. You like Gene Simmons? Yeah. He goes, man, all you gotta do is just take the people's red crayons out of their desk in school. So we were stealing everyone's red crayons. And we'd go out in recess, chewing up red crayons, going, bleh.
That is so gross.
It was awesome, though.
It
was waxy.
Yeah,
a waxy crayon. All right. So that's my story. All right, so if that's X and Y, or if this is X and this is Y, or this is X and this is Y. So notice, two secants, a secant and a tangent, or two tangents. Oh, I meant to have that as a Y. I'm sorry. So you take X minus Y, and you divide it by 2, and this is the equation to get to any of those angles. Now realize, X is gonna should be the larger of the arc lengths, and Y is the shorter. The reason I say that is if you subtract it the other way, you're gonna get a negative number. If you subtract it the other way, you will get a negative answer. Just realize you can't have a negative angle. So this will equal this, will equal this, and it will equal this. That's the pattern you go to. Okay? If they crisscross inside, the angles inside, the only thing different is this becomes a plus sign. So outside minus inside plus. If the angle was at is part of the circle, so it's added into the circle, you have to add it. If the angle is taken away outside of the circle, you have to subtract it. Yeah, question yourself. Yeah.
What do you mean if it crisscrosses inside?
Okay, so if it looks like, let's just add a picture to our notes. And we do this. If we had this, this one will go with x plus y over 2 equals angle 1. Yeah?
Is that where you sound like a linear pair? Like,
I mean, this could have a linear pair, yeah. If they had angle 1 being this, then you'd have to realize this would be 90 minus, or 180 minus whatever that angle is. So you notice how this is the same, except for one sign. So just be cautious. So this would be the chord angle. Cool? Does that make sense?
C.
And then, so how do I do this first one? The angles outside, so is it addition or subtraction?
Subtraction.
So I'm going to go 78 minus divided by
2
equals angle X. Okay, so 78 minus 42, I don't know. What? 36. 36 divided by 2. That's 18 degrees.
18. Oh,
sweet. What about this one? I know, so my unknown is X minus 44. Over 2 equals 30.
60, x minus 44.
Yeah, so do a little algebra. Multiply both sides by 2.
104.
So x equals 104. Pretty easy?
Easy peasy.
Making sense?
Lemon squeezing.
All right. How are these going? All right, can I move on?
I don't know. Can you do that?
All right. So, find the values of X and Y. So it looks like X is this angle. Do what?
Oh, wait. Never mind. What am I? Okay. Shoot.
Am I missing? Okay, so if that's 3, this is 3, right?
Pythagorean
theorem. So I guess what I could do is let's figure out this angle here. So being it's a right angle, that would be, I would do tangent of, it's not tangent, opposite hypotenuse. It's sine of angle 2 equals, sine of Smiley face. Sorry. That's a smile. Nah, oh my gosh. I gotta quit drinking so much. What?
If you put three, the hypotenuse would be five, right?
That, you are right. You are right. Thank you. So sine of 3/5, sine of 60 is, any ideas? Or 3/5?
My sister stole my calculator, so I'm sorry.
It happens.
So I'm being legit.
Oh, wait. That's important. What is it?
Sam says 12.9.
So it's, you do cosine, it would actually be sine in this case.
Would you do second?
Second, yeah.
Boom.
So what are we finding? Second sine of 3/5. 36.86. Okay, so that's what smiley face is. So double that because this whole thing, so times that by 2 and I get what? 73 point, I don't know.
Wait, why are you?
Because this would have been just this angle here. 73.72. Okay. So that's that whole angle outside. So I have this. This being 73.72. And then I have here and here. I need to find y. Gotcha. All right, so how do I find this angle X? I already knew that this one was 36, so I'm going to go 90 minus 36.86, and what do I get there? 53.14 degrees. So that's 53.14 degrees. So double that, and I'm going to get this whole length here. So that's this red would be 106.28. Degrees?
Yeah, so then
and then I'm going to go 360 minus 106.28. I don't know. 253.76. Is that right? I think I did my math right. Eugene, did I do my math right? Good.
Wouldn't you subtract K?
Oh.
If it's outside, you subtract. So you subtract y from 106.28. Wait, I don't.
So being I knew that this was 53.14, that means this arc length has to be 53.14, which means the whole arc length has to be 106.28.
Mm-hmm.
And then from here to here has to be the rest of the circle. So it's going to be 360 minus 106.28 to give me 253.76.
Okay.
Sweet. That'll work. Huh. Which then, if it truly worked, I'm going to borrow your calculator real quick. So if this truly worked, that would mean 253.76 minus 106.28 divided by 2 would be this answer here, and I have to divide that one more time to get angle 2. So see if it works backwards that way. So 253.76 minus 106.28, divide that by 2. That gives me this whole angle is 73.72. Yeah, got it. Divide that by 2. There we go. 36.86. Done. It worked. Cool. All right.
Chapter 10 is our last chapter.
Oh, I don't know. So summarize. So if the vertex of the angle is on the circle, then So if the vertex is on the circle, then it's half the arc. So this distance here, if this is x, this has to be x over 2. Okay? If this distance here is x, then this distance has to be, or this angle has to be x over 2. If it's in the middle, if I had this and this, and I wanted to know this angle, you're going to do the arc plus the arc over 2 to give you the question mark angle. Okay, because that's inside. If it's outside, it's going to be arc minus arc over 2 is equal to the angle. So that's everything figured out for you. So arc plus arc, if the angle's inside the circle, if the angle is on the edge of the circle, it's just divided by 2. If it's outside the circle, you add the two arcs together, or subtract the two arcs and divide by 2. That's it. Is that it? Done? Woo! All right. So let's take a look. Oh, thank you. Oh, dude, who's
Get pranked! Get pranked!
Where'd that go? I don't even know where it went. I just flicked it and no one jumped. All right. Some. I tell you, some people's jokes are so funny. I'm excited to have them again in accelerated geometry next year. All right, let's take a look at 9.6. I asked you to start it, so is there any questions you want me to go over on what you started? Go ahead.
13.
13, holy crow. Okay. Number 13, I think I can walk through a lot of these. Is that okay?
Yeah.
All right, so you're paying attention. All right, thanks. So, make sure you put your name on it, though. I think an easier way to do this problem is to break it into the two circles. Okay, so I'm gonna do small circle and large circle. And then I have small circle, I have this. And large circle, I have this. Is that okay if I broke them apart that way? All right, so let's list what we know. Small circle, I know that this is 40. I don't know what the 40 is here. And then I have x here. And then on big circle, I know that this is 110. Oh, I can find that angle right there. How big is that angle right there got to be?
55.
It's half of it, right? So if this is 55 degrees, then this has to be 55 degrees as well. Agree? Okay. So then that means that this is 55 here. Agreed? Does everyone agree how I pulled it apart? So that means that I'm going to go x minus 40 divided by 2 equals 55.
Wait, wouldn't it be 110 minus?
Okay. So notice this x here is here. The 110 is here. So this big circle is right here. So I'm not drawing it with the small circle. So I don't have a 40 I identify or an X. And then this angle here has to be the same as this angle here, which is the same as this angle here. So I get X minus 40 plus 110. X equals 150. Sweet. That's it. So all I did is I broke the two circles apart, keeping everything constant that I knew. Obviously, in the big circle, I no longer see an X and I no longer see a 40. And in the small circle, I no longer see the 110, so I have to go with that. All right, I'm going to number 11 first. Is that okay so far? We good? Number 11. All right, so I have this, I have this, I have that drawn right? Close enough. I don't know if this line goes through the center, so I wanted to make sure it was way away from it. So I have Y up here. I have this being 50. I have this being X. I have this being 40. And then this being 60. Is that okay? And we want to try and figure out X and Y. So things that I have as go-tos right away, I would know this to be 30 degrees. Why do I know that? It has to be half. So if that's 30, that means that this angle here has to be 100, which means this has to be 80, which means this has to be 80.
Oh, my gosh, you're right.
Which means...
That has to be
100.
Vertical angle, right?
What has to be 100?
Vertical
angle. This can't be 100. Yeah, vertical angle. That is 100. You're right. Which means we're inside, so I can go
y
plus 40 over 2 equals 100. Right? This plus this. No, because it's not at the corner. So that means I get y plus 40 equals 200, y equals 160. Does my answers match up?
Yeah.
Questions on that one? Yeah.
You only double it when it's at the corner?
Right. Okay. So you see that 50 degrees up there in the upper left?
Yeah.
So that would mean this 50 would mean that this right here is 100. I mean, you could go through it that way.
Yeah.
And that would have worked as well, because then you have 100 and 100. That's 200. How do I get to?
Yeah, that would be. That's
okay. More than one way to skin a cat. If you're into skinning cats, yes.
Skinning cats.
Yes. More than one way to skin Sawyer. Which one did you say?
Eight.
Okay.
Mr.
Yo.
Look at Eugene's side. Eugene, show your side.
Why?
Not looking at Eugene.
Wait, why would you not have this?
This 60?
Yeah.
I could have.
And it's turned.
I mean, the 60 is, this is the 60 right here. So this has to be the relationship. So 100 plus 60 is 160 divided by 2 is the 80. So that would work too. That'd be just one more way to go through it. All right, shh, too noisy. Will you guys tell Sawyer to keep quiet? Thank you.
I will.
This is number 8. Is that what you guys asked for?
Yeah.
All right, number 8. I got to record. Okay. Number 8. If this is 34, and this is x plus 6, and then this is 3x minus 2. So the relationship here is this arc minus this arc divided by 2 equals that 34. Agreed? So 3x minus 2 minus x plus 6 divided by 2 equals 34. Is that okay? Hey, why did I put minus x plus 6? Why did I put the x plus 6 in parentheses? Yeah, I have to distribute those negatives. So 3x minus 2 minus x minus 6 over 2 equals 34. So that becomes 68 on this side. 3x minus x is 2x minus 8. So 2x is equal to 76. So x equals 38. Sweet. That'll work. Yeah. Devin, you had your hand up for a bit. You sure? Are you sad because I ignored you? Okay. Yes, sir. Number 6. Okay, so those are two tangents, right? Number 6. So that's x. And this over here is 247. Okay. I could see it real easy how you'd get mixed up on that. Remember, a tangent touches the line once. So we have two tangents. So this 247 goes from here all the way to here. Is that okay for 247? So how big would this angle be right here? How big is this arc? 360 minus 247. What does that come out to? 113. So now I know 247 minus 113 divided by 2 equals x. And whatever that works out to. Does that make sense? Yes, sir. Number 3.
It's always those two arcs that always equal that.
Divided by 2. Number 3. There. Are we good?
Yeah.
Okay. Number 3. What was, wait.
Never mind, sorry.
You good? All right.
Can you do number 14?
Yeah, I'll do number 3 right now, then I'll get to 14. Remind me. All right, number 3. These are on the interior, right? So I have this and this somehow. Okay, so that's 145, this one's 145, this one's 85, and that's x. So they're inside, so it's going to be the same equation, but plus. So 145 plus 85 over 2 will give me x, whatever that works out to. If that angle happened outside, it'd be minus, so that sign changes. Someone asked for one, I ignored you.
14.
Dude, are you kidding? That's the big hard one to, man.
Why are you making Mr. Skip do hard math problems, huh?
I know. It's out of control.
No.
But it's Johnny, so I'm happy to do it.
Amen. Have fun drawing all that.
I'll be with y'all in a few minutes. Fiddlesticks.
go back to chapter 6 with you number 2. Thank
you. What I needed.
All right. Oh, yeah, yeah. All right. So this is for. This is 50.
That's so true.
This is 80. B, 7, C, D, 2, 3, F, 1, E, A, Five, that's 6, that's 9, that's 10, this is 8, this is 20.
God, you need to get your butt off of it.
No butts and face. Do I have everything drawn up there I'm supposed to?
I think so. I don't know. All right. So,
what? Oh, it's number 14. Thank you. All right. I'll do the rest in blue.
Draw the letters.
What?
Yeah, all the letters.
Let him do it.
All right. So, I can tell you that this angle here is 25 because it came to the corner. It's half of this. Agreed?
FC is a radii.
Do FC is a radii. Good.
So is FB.
Thank you, and so is FE. Yeah, all right. Oh, this angle 5. This has to be, being this is tangent, this has to be 40 degrees. Okay. This whole angle here. Let's see if that's 40. So this here, that's 100. And so I go 100 minus 50, which is 100 minus 50 is 50 divided by 2. That's 25. Okay. And then I can find this angle here, number 3. So I have 80. Plus 50 is 130. 130 divided by 2 is 65. This opens up. This has to be half of that, so that has to be 40. Oh, my goodness. And then, oh, wait. This, that's 100, so that has to be 50. Oh, that has to be 20, thank you, because it's a central angle, good. We're still trying to find 6, so that, I don't have enough for that yet. 7.
So, would you say, the triangle with?
Which angle are you looking at?
I'm trying to figure. Trying to figure out 6. So couldn't you say that because of angle 1 and 9 you would figure it out?
Angle 1, hang on, angle 1 and angle 9
is by A. So you add those together, which is 65, and then so you know the third angle is 115, and then couldn't you do vertical and you all know that this works. No, never mind.
So okay, I like how you're thinking. Oh boy. I feel like there's one.
So E to B is the diameter, right?
Yes.
So you can figure out
Oh good. So this has to be 100 up here, right? Because from here to here, because it's diameter, good. And
so you can figure out the other part of the linear pair or not the linear
pair. Up here?
And yeah, you can figure out
So
that's 115. No, you can figure out EFC.
EFC.
So it'd be 160, and then
160. I agree.
And then subtract that from 50 is 110. So DC is 110.
DC is 110.
The arc.
Holy crap! Ben, you're so smart.
110. Why are we getting that? Oh,
wait,
when? And then angle 6 is.
Yeah, and so then you figure out angle.
How am I getting that to be 110 though?
Because 50.
Because you got EFC is 160, subtract 50 because it's a central angle. You have the 50 from ED.
You will, Sawyer. Everyone else is pretty much in the clear.
Let us see. 50 and 20 is 70, and so you have to get that to add up to 180. So it'd be 110, because it's a diagonal.
You have to find all the freaking
intersections. One.
Who comes up
Where?
With this problem?
So look, wait. So this is the central angle, right? So you've got this is 160, subtract that, okay. Is 110, okay. So then you figure out angle 6 plus 110 plus 1.
110 plus 20 is 130, so that's angle 6.
Yeah.
110 plus 20 is 130, so that's 65. 65 and 65 is 130, so this has to be 50. Holy crow! Oh, and then our last angle, to find angle 10. So I have 40, 65. That's 105 plus 25. 105 plus 25 is 130. So that has to be 50, which is half of that. Yep, good.
Ay, ay, ay.
Good stuff.
Stick it, Johnny.
I'm sorry.
Woo!
Not figure out math, Johnny.
No, I can't. All right. So make sure the rest of that sheet is done, and we'll collect that manana. That's tomorrow for those of you who don't speak stirrup. And then review worksheet. What, Mr. Stirrupbutt? 9-4 to 9-6. Okay. Holy moly, guacamole. Yes. But I did almost all.